How does silver stack up to the other investment classes? One of the primary reasons I stack silver is because it represents an asset class that is not denominated in any fiat currency. Remember that fiat currencies are backed by nothing and are basically an IOU from the government that issues it. Silver is classified as a commodity metal and its value stands on its own. One of the key reasons for this is because its value is based upon its own relative value as money. What is relative value? Relative value is a method of determining an asset's value that takes into account the value of similar assets. This is in contrast to absolute value, which looks at an asset's intrinsic value and does not compare it to other assets. In order to obtain a relative value of silver, you would compare it to the value of other similar assets that are also considered money. Silver value exists because of its natural rarity, visual appearance, and the multitude of uses it has in various applications. Silver was first used as money in present-day Turkey around 2,600 years ago. There are other financial assets not denominated in a fiat currency. Commodities can have relative and intrinsic value and are generally considered to derive their own value. Here are some commodities that can be investment traded. There is energy traded commodities like oil, light crude, heating oil, natural gas, unleaded gas, and Brent crude. Metals such as gold, silver, platinum, and copper. The traded agriculture commodities are corn, soybeans, and wheat. Meat and livestock includes lean hogs, live cattle, and feeder cattle, and the consumer commodities of coca, coffee, cotton, and sugar. One concern with putting your wealth in traded commodities is market manipulation. Soaring commodity prices are a warning sign of imminent hyperinflation, so the bankers have had constant suppression of most commodity markets. Another issue is that few commodities can be held directly by the average investor. It's not practical to attempt to hold bushels of wheat or barrels of oil or warehouses full of lumber. Someone might say, well, what about buying commodity exchange traded funds, often referred to as ETFs? With the impending economic circumstances we are soon to face, I wouldn't consider it wise to buy any form of ETF right now. With ETFs, there is always a third-party risk involved, and they represent an asset that you don't actually have the physical possession of. And as we silver stackers say, if you don't hold it, then you don't own it. When comparing all the traded commodities, gold and silver are really the only viable options that an average investor can actually take physical possession of. Remember that gold and silver are money. In terms of wealth preservation, they are stores of value and are universally regarded as wealth safe havens. It is the liquidity of gold and silver that have historically maintained their status as a safe haven. Other common asset classes for investments include stocks or equities, bonds or other fixed income investments, cash or cash equivalents such as money market funds, futures and other financial derivatives. These asset classes are denominated in fiat currencies, and their value will be directly affected as fiat currencies begin to fail. The price of these asset classes will follow. Real estate or other tangible assets are not necessarily denominated in fiat currency. They derive their own value and thus can be another mechanism to store personal wealth. The big difference between real estate, other tangible assets, and precious metals is that they are not considered a liquid asset and are more difficult to convert into another asset class when it comes time to sell them. Another aspect that differentiates real estate from precious metals is that they're not usually divisible. Land can be parceled, of course, but a home is usually considered a fixed physical asset and is usually valued and sold in its entirety. Another is fungibility. No two pieces of real estate are exactly alike, and thus their values will obviously be different. And since values are subjective to the buyer and the seller individually, this removes the reliability or consistency for the value of any future transactions. You could never determine with absolute certainty the future value of real estate or any other tangible asset in this class. Next is durability. Homes, cars, boats, or whatever tangible asset you may have will eventually require some kind of expense for upkeep or maintenance. Usually without this maintenance, the asset will begin to degrade and lose value over time. Portability can also be a factor to consider. For me, real estate or other tangible assets become a consideration for the preservation of my wealth if the real estate is the home I choose to reside in. If the land is purposed to produce a crop or maintain livestock. If the tangible asset is a piece of equipment that has a viable utility. A vehicle to be used as a required means of transportation. Or if the asset is essential to run my business or sustain and protect my family. You might notice that I didn't include income-producing real estate or income-producing assets. The reason for this is that if these assets are dependent upon a third party to generate value, they could manifest themselves into a real problem. If the third party is present and fully able to pay for the use of these assets, all is well. But as soon as they can't, these assets would most probably only become a burden of expense to maintain or pay licenses, fees, and taxes on. This kind of potential liability would become a drain to your personal wealth. Once economic conditions change, this type of income-producing asset will once again be part of my financial plan. The most modern and controversial asset class to consider for wealth preservation is digital currencies. Before I go on, I know this can be a very intense subject in the stacking community. I'm not here to convince you of anything, only to present the facts as I know them so that you can make informed decisions about your wealth preservation. So I ask that you hear this portion out, but if it's something that you absolutely can't listen to, then I ask that you skip forward to this timestamp to finish viewing the content. Well, I guess you're still here, so I will continue. Not all cryptos are classified as currencies. Many are platforms for blockchain applications and are not designed to be used as a broad medium of exchange. Digital currencies get their value through scarcity. For simplicity, I will only discuss Bitcoin in this video as a potential asset for personal wealth preservation. There are some solid points that can justify Bitcoin as a viable wealth retention alternative, but there are also some circumstances that must be understood. Because Bitcoin is a new, emerging technology market with a low market cap compared to other traditional markets, quite a bit of market volatility is to be expected. The more total money that flows through a market, along with high volumes of trading, is what serves to stabilize a market. This chart shows where Bitcoin is compared to other traditional investment market caps. As you can see, there's no comparison between these investment assets and Bitcoin. This should clearly illustrate why Bitcoin and, to a lesser degree, silver are such volatile markets. The smaller the market cap, the more a wealth institution or small group of wealth individuals can directly influence a market. This is exactly why it has been so easy for the banks to manipulate the silver market. Fortunately, those days are limited as laws are being better enforced and court cases are starting to find the guilty actually guilty. In 2019, despite all its volatility, Bitcoin's price has risen more than 300%. How has Bitcoin performed against other asset classes such as stocks, bonds, precious metals, and oil more recently? This table shows that Bitcoin has outperformed every major asset in all three chosen investment periods on an absolute return basis. The numbers speak for themselves. Given these options, the choice for which asset I would choose is crystal clear. Bitcoin has been the best performing asset of the last 10 years. Safe haven in Bitcoin. Traditionally, US Treasuries, gold, and the Swiss franc have been considered the premier safe haven assets. Bitcoin has shown to have an inverse correlation to stocks in the past and is becoming another viable option as a safe haven asset. As Bitcoin's volatility becomes stable, it only offers a more attractive alternative as a safe haven source. There are some considerations to understand before choosing Bitcoin as a wealth retention or safe haven asset. Because of its volatility, there should be a clear expectation that whatever wealth is placed into Bitcoin will have to endure the flow of the market until a profitable liquidation price is offered. This means that you may not be able to exit your wealth out of the market immediately if the market happens to be on a downswing at that time. Patience is a critical skill that must be practiced if you want to enter into the cryptocurrency markets. The price history of the Bitcoin market has clearly demonstrated that the value is in a long-term upward path with no reason to believe that this overall trend will change. All you have to do is be able to wait out the volatility. But as more institutional money continues to enter the market, I believe we will see the radical swings of price volatility begin to subside. I think it's important to understand that you won't need to own a lot of Bitcoin. Not even a whole Bitcoin. A fraction is fine. When investors get caught at the last minute trying to convert their wealth into the traditional safe haven assets, the market access to those assets will either dry up very quickly, the markets will shut down, or the price will be so high that it wouldn't make any sense to place your wealth there. There is only so much physical gold and even less physical silver in the actual markets, and it has been postulated that much of even this gold and silver doesn't really physically exist. When investors start panicking as they see their stocks and other investment prices plummet, they will be willing to put their money anywhere they can to stop the bleeding. The next real liquid option will be Bitcoin, in my opinion. Money will begin pouring into the Bitcoin market, and this will launch the price in the same direction as gold and silver markets, straight up. The difference being the increased price percentage of Bitcoin, I feel, will be exponential compared to the precious metal markets. So, even having a small amount of Bitcoin before the crisis could equate to a life-changing value of wealth during or after the crisis. The metals will do really well, but they won't compare to the percentage price increase that Bitcoin will see during a full-blown crisis. We need to be mindful that this next financial crisis is not going to involve only the US, but the entire world. As the US dollar is the benchmark for the value of all global currencies, when the US dollar begins to fail, it will affect every currency that hasn't sufficiently backed itself with a true, tangible asset, as we see that many nations have begun to do. Like the precious metals, Bitcoin is also a global asset and becoming more global every day. I believe the global aspect of digital currencies will, in effect, promote the adoption of Bitcoin or some other digital currency to serve as a means of exchange for international commerce. Just like precious metals, Bitcoin is a store of value. It's extremely liquid. It's easily divisible. It has fungibility. It's durable, it can't wear out, and it's rare, even more rare than gold or silver. For me, Bitcoin or any cryptocurrency will never take the place of precious metals, and it's not a substitute for precious metals. Only another financial asset option that meets the criteria that will retain my personal wealth during a financial crisis. conclusion. Wealth retention strategies are all about looking forward. We stack precious metals today not because we feel that they're valuable today, but because we believe that when the fiat fractional reserve banking system collapses and the Fed and the central banks finally lose control of propping up the markets, it will be our precious metals that will retain our wealth through this trying time. When developing your wealth retention strategy, emotion should not be a factor. Sound decisions based on factual data and a clear understanding of the asset and its market is what is essential to make the kind of decisions that need to be made. It's my belief that silver is by and far the most undervalued wealth retention asset in the world right now. All I'm trying to accomplish is wealth retention until this global monetary crisis, collapse, reset, or whatever it turns out to be is over. In order to do this, I'm looking for assets that are not fiat denominated and won't be negatively affected by a dollar revaluation or collapse. What would be your choices for assets that you would trust to retain your personal wealth? Do you believe that income properties assets are good investments during a financial crisis? Let me know in the comments section below. A big thank you to all who support this channel, especially to those who take the time to like, share, and comment. I don't monetize my channel, so your likes, shares, and comments really help the channel to grow and be seen by others. If you're not yet a subscriber, hit the subscribe button. Then don't forget to select the notification bell to be notified as soon as I post up new content. And as always, feel free to share this content with all.